Welcome to this week's edition of Way Back Wednesday. I'm Karen Stone, the Museum Division Manager for St. Mary's County, and today I have a story about studs and the sport of kings from right here in Leonardtown, a most historic place. I chose this story this week because in a normal year, we would be looking forward to the Preakness race this coming Saturday. The first Tuesday after the third Monday in March was by tradition court day in Leonardtown, the day big cases were tried. But more interestingly, and perhaps more importantly, it was also Stud Horse Day in Leonardtown. This was the day horse owners came from all over the county to sell their stallion stud services. The day was celebrated with a carnival atmosphere, complete with drummers, agents, gamblers, and traders of every description who were looking for a chance to turn a fast dollar, many of which were not always completely legal. Beribboned stallions took over the streets along with buggies, carriages, and all sorts of farm machinery. In advance of this day, many of these stallions were promoted via flyers, which included their picture and their bloodlines. This was a big money day for their owners, as these horses were prime breeding stock for both workers and racers. And speaking of races, Leonardtown once had a popular thoroughbred racetrack. The first one was on the east side of Hollywood Road, on land now occupied by the Governmental Center and the Leonard Hall Junior Naval Academy, not far from where I'm sitting. The track then moved across the street, running from Doctor's Crossing Drive to Mile Post Lane. This area was known as Racetrack Farm. The track was also site of local jousting tournaments, yes, jousting, which were great spectacles just like their medieval counterparts. Did you know that jousting is Maryland's official state sport? In 1866, John Singleton Mosby, the Confederate Grey Ghost, served as one of the tournament judges. He was safe here, being in sympathetic territory, but also having been given papers of protection by President Grant. To go along with the racetrack, there was a jockey club, which opened in May of 1863. It was a countywide club open to all, and lasted until 1910, when racing in Leonardtown came to an end. Stud Horse Day continued, however, for at least another 30 years. Thanks for being with us today. I'll see you again next week for another edition of Way Back Wednesday.